transforms and partial differential equations, MA 8353, unit 5, Z transforms and difference equations. So in this unit we have to discuss some two more questions. Okay, so sum number one, find Z transform of 1 by r. So first we have to apply the formula. Z transform of f of n equal to sigma n equal to 1 to infinity f of n into z power minus n. So z of 1 by n is equal to, so in the f of n place we have to apply the function 1 by n equal to sigma n equal to 1 to infinity. So f of z can be taken as 1 by n into z power minus n. So sigma n equal to 1 to infinity, so first we have to apply n equal to 1, so 1 by 1 z power minus 1. So first one is z power minus 1. Again secondly, put n equal to 2, 1 by 2 z power minus 2, n equal to 3, 1 by 3 z power minus 3, and so on. So z inverse can be taken as 1 by z, 1 by 2 into z power minus 2 is 1 by z square, plus 1 by 3 into z cube can be taken, z power minus 3 can be taken as 1 by z cube. So this result can be compared with the logarithmic formula. So x plus x square by 2 plus x square by x cube by 3 etc up to, which is equal to, the right hand side formula is minus log 1 minus x. So in the place of x we have to take 1 by z, and in the place of 1 by z square can be taken as x square, and 1 by z cube can be taken as x cube. So this can be compared with formula, so which is equal to, right hand side of the formula is minus log 1 minus x, so minus log 1 minus x can be treated as 1 by z, so minus log 1 minus 1 by z. So minus log LCM, so z minus 1 by z. Again let us apply the power rule, implies logarithm of z minus 1 by z whole power minus 1. So the reciprocal of this value is logarithm of z by z minus 1, hence the product. So let us move to second sum. State and prove the initial value theorem in Z transform. First we have to write down the statement and then prove this theorem. So the statement of the initial value theorem is, let us take z of f of n equal to capital F of z, then f of 0 equal to limit n tends to infinity f of z. This is the statement of the initial value theorem. So we have to prove this theorem. So first we have to take the right hand side of the definition is f of z equal to, f of z can be taken as f of z equal to z of f of n. So f of z equal to z of f of n. So the definition of z of f of n can be taken as sigma n equal to 0 to infinity f of n into z power minus n. So this is the definition of a Z transform. So we have to put n equal to 0. So n equal, put n equal to 0 means f of 0 z power minus 0. So f of 0 z power minus 0. Again n equal to 1, f of 1 z power minus 1. And again we have to put 2, f of 2 z power minus 2, etc. Next step, f of 0, anything by 0 is equal to 1, plus f of 1 z inverse can be taken as 1 by z plus f of z, z power minus 2 can be taken as 1 by z square. So we are applying limit on both sides, limit n tends to infinity on both sides. So limit n tends to infinity of f of z equal to limit n tends to infinity of f of 0 plus f of 1 into 1 by z plus f of 2 into 1 by z square. Straight away applying the limit n tends to infinity in this expression, so f of 0 is fixed, limit f of 1 is fixed, so limit n tends to infinity can be applying in z only, so z tends to infinity, so 1 by infinity plus f of 2 is fixed, and z tends to infinity is 1 by z square. So f of 0, f of 1, 1 by infinity is value is 0, 1 by infinity is 0, anything by infinity equal to 0, plus f of 2, 1 by infinity square is 0. So the final answer of the initial value theorem is limit n tends to infinity f of z equal to f of 0. This is the proof of an initial value theorem.